Every year, organ transplants save thousands of lives. But what happens if your body rejects the new organ? Hey guys, Julia here for DNews. The first successful liver transplant was performed in 1954. Since then, the techniques have improved over the years. 29,000 organ transplants are performed in the US every year, but it's a tricky business. Matches are rare and a rejection can get pretty nasty. And rejections happen more than you think. While some types of transplants are more successful, like cornea transplants have a 75% success rate over 10 years, and 5-year organ survival rates for heart, kidney, and liver transplants is about 70%. But on the other hand, according to the National Kidney Foundation, 17% of kidney transplants fail within 3 years, while the survival rate of lung transplants is surprisingly low, like 66% after just 3 years, according to a report from the Children's Hospital of Pittsburgh. When a person gets a new limb or organ, their body obviously recognizes it as foreign, and like most foreign things, it tries to get rid of it. So what happens when somebody's body rejects a transplant? There are 3 main kinds of rejection: hyperacute, acute, and chronic. Hyperacute happens almost instantaneously, within minutes or hours after the transplant. The recipient's body starts to reject the new organ or limb. Acute rejection can occur within a few months to a year from transplantation, and chronic rejection can happen over a few years. Basically, your body uses its immune system to fight off any foreign invader, whether that's a virus or a new liver. A hugely important part of the immune system is the major histone compatibility complex, or MHC. The MHC's main job is to differentiate between your body cells and not your body cells. The MHC is made up mostly of glycoproteins on the walls of your cells. They act as tags that say, "This is me!" When a white blood cell reads that tag, it's like, okay, it's you, I won't destroy you. There's over 20 genes that code for the MHC and over 50 variations per gene, so there's a lot of combinations, I mean a lot. That's why it's so hard to match a donor to a recipient. When the MHC recognizes the tags as foreign, it starts a process that triggers destruction of the weird, scary, unknown cells. Your immune system produces T cells, which go in and target the foreign cells and induces apoptosis, or programmed cell death. Other cells and proteins get involved too, like phagocytes, which basically eat up the dead cells. Anyways, it's a whole messy process. You can tell your body is rejecting an organ in a few ways: swelling or redness, generally feeling ill, and specific kinds of organ failure. But there are ways to beat rejection. Most of it involves immunosuppressive drugs, which can include corticosteroids such as prednisone. While right after the transplant, the dose of medication is pretty high, but doctors might wean the dose over the course of a year to a maintenance phase. But the thing is, most people have to be on the medications for life, sometimes up to 12 different medications every day. And because the drugs lower their immune system, they put themselves at risk for infections, illnesses, and even certain types of cancer. They have to forever walk a fine line between rejection and infection. But research is being done to try to remove the need for such drugs. Some recent research from UCSF holds some promise. In a study published in the American Journal of Transplantation, the researchers used a 2-tiered approach to tackle rejection. First, they administered a drug called cyclophosphamide to mice, which had transplanted tissues. The drug effectively killed off most of those T cells I mentioned earlier. Then the mice received cell therapy, which grew populations of certain cells called Tregs, and like that name suggests, they regulate T cells. And with more of these cells in place, they hold back the immune system from rejecting the organ or limb. According to the study, nearly 80% of the mice accepted a transplant without the need for a lifelong regimen of drugs. And this technique proved successful in one human patient already. So that could be pretty cool one day, but it's clear more research is needed. Changing gears for a second, NASA is about to fly by Pluto, and we're gonna do a live Google Hangout with our space producer, Ian O'Neill, and a special guest inside Mission Control. Come join on July 14th at 1 p.m. Pacific, 4 p.m. Eastern, and RSVP on the event page for a reminder. There's a link in the description too. Have you ever had a transplant? Tell us your story down in the comments below. Hit those like and subscribe buttons and keep coming back to DNews. We've got new episodes every day of the week.